In this video, you will learn how to use Amazon Rekognition bulk analysis to analyze an image dataset, which will provide you with the overview of your dataset, showcasing the distribution of unsafe images across moderation taxonomies. Once you get a good insight of your images and know where the problems come from, you then can utilize the Rekognition custom moderation feature to train an adapter, enhancing moderation accuracy to meet your specific business needs. Now let's get started. From the Amazon Rekognition page in the AWS console, select bulk analysis. You can see any previous bulk analysis tasks on this page. Click Start Bulk Analysis button to create a new task. First, you need to choose an adapter to analyze your dataset with. By default, no adapter is selected, and the base content moderation model is used. If you have a trained adapter in the past, you can select it from the drop-down list. Provide a name for the bulk analysis task. I will call it Demo Heat Symbol Job, because later the dataset I'm using is about heat symbol. You can set your minimum confidence threshold. I will leave it 50% as a default setting. Now you must provide the image you want to analyze. You can either import images from an Amazon S3 bucket or upload image directly from your local computer. I will specify an S3 URI. If you prefer to use your own KMS key, for example, your image in the S3 bucket was encrypted using a self-managed KMS key, you can choose it from here so Rekognition can access the image from the S3 bucket you provided. Now click Start Analysis. This will start the analysis. We now have to wait for the job to complete. Now the job is completed. You can see the status become succeeded, and then we can click on the job name in the list, which will bring us to the bulk analysis detail page. On the top, it shows general information such as name of the job, the model moderation model we use for this bulk analysis, and also the input output metadata location on S3. In the middle, we can see in this dataset, Rekognition flagged 29 images under heat symbol. And then further scroll down, we can see the actual images. And we see the images are flaming letters. They are considered safe, but the Rekognition flagged them as heat symbol. So we want to use this dataset to train a custom moderation adapter to improve the accuracy of heat symbol category. You can do that, connect to the custom moderation process by clicking on this verify prediction button. But before go there, you want to make sure to train a custom moderation adapter for enhanced accuracy, you want to make sure you have at least 20 false positives or 50 false negatives for one or more labels. In my case, I know I have 29 false positive under the heat symbol category, so I'm good to go. I will click on this verify prediction button. It brings me to the custom moderation annotation page where I can provide human ground truth label for the images for the model adapter training. So let's take a look at the first image. This is considered a safe image, but Rekognition flagged it as a heat symbol. So first of all, I will confirm this is a false positive. It is not heat symbol, and also assign the proper label to it. In this case, it's safe, so I'm not choosing the other category, I'm choosing safe. You can apply the same setting to multiple images on the same page by utilizing the Select All Images on the Page button. I will repeat this process for all the 29 images in my dataset. All right, now I have annotated all the 29 images. You can go click on this Save Verification buttons, which will save the status of your annotation. This is especially useful when you're annotating a larger data set, so you can save the status in the middle and come back later to resume the task. Now I can click on Train an Adapter to start the custom moderation adapter training. I will give the project a name. In this case, I call it a demo. And then give a name to my adapter. I'll call it a demo adapter, a heat symbol false positive adapter. And you can give it a description. So by default, Rekognition will do the auto split, split the data into training and the testing data set. You can also specify a separate data set for training and testing if you already have them ready. And then there's a data encryption setting similar as bulk analysis for the where you can specify the KMS key. It uses the default setting confidence threshold, which is 50%. You can also select enable this auto update. What it means is whenever there's a new base model available from Rekognition moderation, by enable this, Rekognition will automatically train a new adapter based on the latest Rekognition moderation model. Now I will click on this button to train adapter, which will take a few minutes to complete. We'll come back to check the status. After training completes, we can inspect the adapter details and see its performance by clicking on the adapter name. On this page, we can see the overall performance and see that the false positive performance improved by 96%. We can see the per label performance for heat symbols under the false positive tab. There was an approximately 96% improvement as well. Down below, you can see all the images in your data set and their predictions. Inspecting these predictions will help you to determine whether you need to focus when creating a new adapter. Follow the annotation and verification best practices when verifying predictions. Under the Use Adapter tab, you can see how to use your adapter for inference. Your unique adapter ID is displayed. Copy this adapter ID and provide it to the appropriate operation when getting predictions. A sample AWS CLI command and a sample Python code is provided on this page. All right, in this video, you learned how to use Amazon Bulk Analysis workflow to analyze a batch of images and then train a custom moderation adapter on the verified bulk analysis predictions. Thank you for watching.